Oh yeah.
Hello everyone, my name's MV Perry, and today we're going to be talking about the 9 types of fandoms. First of all, what is a fandom? Well, it's a group of people who really like a certain thing. It can be a show, game, book, movie series, band, anime, you name it. There are many different fandoms, and some of them are good, some of them are bad. Most of all, they get pretty cringy the farther you go down the rabbit hole. The first type of fandom is the pop fandom. And this is a fandom that's pop, meaning popular, and kind of oversaturated. Seriously, it's so popular that even normies claim to be into it. You might find merch of it at a normal store or even celebrities talking about it. On the other hand, it could just be really good and everyone likes it. Kind of like how Mickey Mouse is super famous and everyone likes Mickey Mouse, right? Same with SpongeBob. Everybody knows SpongeBob. But of course, it could also just be a trend because Netflix announced some new series or something like that. You know what I'm talking about. Next type of fandom is the cult fandom. And the cult is like a small group of followers who are really dedicated to something. Maybe it was an indie game or a B-movie, but whatever it is, the fandom is very, very passionate about it. They post about it, cosplay it, create content about it, and most of all, they talk about it. That's what they do all day, is they just sit on their computer talking about Super Mega Magical Girl X. Not a real game, but you know what I'm saying. Don't get me wrong, there are actually a ton of people in the cult fandoms, but compared to the major franchises, these are relatively small. Next type of fandom is the non-existent one, and you know, if it's non-existent, it shouldn't be on this list, right? This one is more of a severe case of the cult. Like, we're talking maybe 3 people. Okay, that's an exaggeration, but really, there are some things out there that no one is into except like 3 people. What are some examples? Well, I can't really give any because I don't know what they are. Next type of fandom is the elitist fandom. The elitists are groups of people who think they're superior to everyone else who isn't into what they're into. Sorry, JoJo fans, but I gotta call you out on this one. The people in this type of fandom think they're smarter and constantly speak in terms that only the fans would understand. Next type of fandom is the toxic fandom. Now, I'm not gonna say for sure which fandom is toxic and which fandoms aren't, but this is a fandom that is really annoying, hateful, and filled to the brim with gatekeeping. People here hate not only on the rest of the world, but on each other. And if anyone new tries to join, they get destroyed instantly. Like, maybe you ship 2 characters who are obviously supposed to be together, and then you get a bunch of haters saying, "No way, you ship that? What a normie.
You don't ship blank and blank. We're gonna cancel you ASAP, no cap."
Now, one thing I really want to make clear is that some fandoms are a mix of things, and there are different sections to fandoms, so just because one side of the fandom is toxic doesn't mean the whole fandom is toxic. And I'm actually going to give the example of My Hero Academia and Undertale. Both of those franchises get a bad rap for having toxic fandoms. Yes, they definitely have toxic people in those fandoms, but I've met a lot of really nice people and chill people in these communities as well. So remember to keep that in mind. Next type of fandom is the welcoming fandom. And this is like the opposite of the toxic fandom. Literally everyone is nice, welcoming, and friendly. Beginners or people who are new will fit in perfectly, and even the veterans don't act like snobs. It's really hard to find fandoms like this, and the smaller the fandom is, the higher the chance of having a nice community. Because part of the reason fandoms are so toxic is because there's a lot of people in it, and humanity is corrupted. Then again, you could also have this small fandom and they all think they're better than you, and that's kind of annoying, so I don't know. Next type of fandom is the split fandom. And this is a tricky one because the franchise is loved by many people, but a big difference in the games or the movies or whatever it is splits the fandom into 2 or more factions. For example, the current Star Wars movies. Half of the fandom thinks it's trash and the other half thinks it's art. Or even Legend of Zelda. You have people who think the 2D games are the best, and then you have the Ocarina of Time fans who prefer the 3D games. Me. And then you have the kids who only played Breath of the Wild, and that's the only exposure they have to Legend of Zelda, so nothing else can beat Breath of the Wild, right? Next type of fandom is the struggling fandom. This is a sad one because it's basically a fandom that once flourished and was great, but over time it's been weathered down into nothingness. The biggest example I have for this is the MLP or Brony fandom. It was really active back in around 2014 with parodies, memes, and even good music being made about MLP, like, seriously, good music. But now, I mean, I don't know what happened to the bronies. I guess they grew up. There used to be like MLP memes just all over the internet, and now it's almost like it doesn't exist. It's really weird. And last but not least is the theory fandom. And this is the fandom who is so obsessed with every single detail of information they can find, and they put it all together and come up with theories for what actually happened or who was the killer behind this, or you know, I'm just making up random stuff, but Five Nights at Freddy's is a great example. There are so many theories for Five Nights at Freddy's. Some of them maybe were intended by Scott Cawthon, but maybe some of them were just totally made up. But the people in the theory fandom get so into it that they can really convince you that they found a true theory. You know that picture of the guy who's like putting together all this stuff in his basement or on the wall? This is basically the theory fandom people. And like I said, all these different fandoms that I've mentioned are just different aspects to a fandom. It's very unlikely that the fandom that you're into is just one of these. Usually it's a combination of a few of these things. Anyways, what are your favorite fandoms? Comment down below. As always, my name's MV Perry, and I'll see you in the next video.